We're talking with Susie O'Brien and Stephen Senatiempo. And when it comes to talking about The Voice, Stephen's against The Voice. Susie's on board, so we get both sides of it today. A bit of a controversy about the Yes posters that are being used outside polling booths, saying their colour sort of reflects the official AEC posters. I think we can see here they do look very similar. Now, the claim here is that it looks like then the message is coming from the government to say vote yes. Stephen, I don't know how that helps everybody. Everyone knows the government says vote yes, and most people arc up when the government tells them to do anything anyway.
Yeah, look, I'm a little bit sort of, you know, neither here nor there about it. I mean, if it's a deliberate attempt to try and confuse people by making them the same colour, then OK, it needs to be called out. But I think the ASC have come up with a decision where they're going to make sure that the signs are far enough away that they can't be confused. And I think most people have made their mind up already anyway.
Yeah, I don't think it's a big issue. I really only mention it because I don't want to say that people are running a protection racket for the Yes case. Let's have a look at what Peter Dutton said on The Voice today.
The Prime Minister's made a decision to try and separate Australians depending on when they came here or their heritage and their ancestry, and that's just not something that the Australian public is going to accept.
Yeah, there we go. There's Peter Dutton. I've got to pick this up now with Stephen. You want to have this argument. Now, there's Peter Dutton making this case that the government wants to divide Australians when The Voice is about bringing them together. I am not running a protection racket at all. I have criticised elements of the Yes campaign for many, many times. Just because I argue my case of why I support Yes and have done for 10 years doesn't mean I'm running a protection racket for the Yes case, Stephen.
Okay, Chris. All right. Look, I disagree with all of your points on this. And, when you say that this is supposed to bring the country together, I think the proof is in the pudding. It's already divided the country. That ship has already sailed.
Yeah, it sure has. It is very, very divisive. And Susie, what do you make of where we're at the moment? The latest poll out today, interestingly enough, from Essential, shows a slight tightening, that the Yes vote has picked up by a point or two within the margin of error, a long way behind still. But this is the sort of the swallow that the Yes case was looking for a month ago may have arrived in the latest poll.
Yeah, look, I think everyone just wants it to be over. Like, even those of us who support it, like you and me, not Stephen, we want it to be over. It's probably not going to get up. We're going to look back at this as a very divisive time. At least we look at the marriage equality. That was very divisive and very hurtful for some of those communities, but it got up. We've gone through all of this and it's probably not going to get up. And I think we will look back and see this as a huge missed opportunity and a very sad time that this whole debate has been hijacked, possibly on both sides, where you've got the Yes vote, people calling the others racist, you've got the No vote running this incredibly powerful and very effective scare campaign, and in the middle there are people who say, I still don't really understand what's going on, so I'm just going to vote no because I don't really get it. So, I think we will look back and see this as a lesson in how not to run a referendum.
Yeah, it's been pretty messy. Midnight Oil, Peter Garrett and Midnight Oil have put out a little clip on this. No surprise as to which vote they're supporting.
Peter Garrett here for the Oils. You've probably guessed we're voting yes in the referendum. We've been singing about this stuff for years. We love Oz deeply. We think it's important. Of course, your vote's totally up to you. But don't get sucked in by all the bull scare campaigns. If you don't know, find out. Google Yes23. Thanks, as always, for listening.
Yeah, whichever way you're going to vote, this has been something I've been saying for many, many weeks, many, many months. If you don't know, find out. This idea that if you don't know, you should vote no is pretty nutty, pretty nutty. It's not the way Aussies are. Yep. If you don't know, find out and make up your own mind either way. I just want to finish up on American politics now and show you a little bit of President Joe Biden. We're familiar with seeing Joe Biden after he's tried to read his scripted remarks, look around to find somebody to tell him where to go, which direction to go. He so often stuffs it up. It is excruciating to watch. But, of course, Donald Trump, he's not shy about these things. Listen to him here mocking the president.
Does anybody think he's going to make it to the starting gate? I mean, the guy can't find his way off of a stage. Look, here's a stage. Here's a stage. I've never seen this stupid stage before, right? I've never seen it. But if I walk left, there's a stair. And if I walk right, there's a stair. And this guy gets up. Where am I? Where the hell am I?
He sure is an entertainer. Would be funny if he fell off the stage then. We're just about out of time. I checked today to see when I was first saying Biden wouldn't run, and I've gone back as far as July last year. But Stephen and Susie, just we've only got 30 seconds. Give us a quick summation of whether you think Joe Biden will run or not, and who might run instead, Stephen.
I don't think he can. I think that young Kennedy might be the best option. But I'm starting to think the best thing that might be for the world is for Donald Trump to win again so that he's out in 4 years and it's all over and we can move on past this period in history.
Quickly, Susie?
I guess for me it's... Yeah, I'm interested to see whether Donald Trump is going to win, going to run again. I mean, he's facing a $250 million lawsuit, which may see him stripped of being able to operate businesses in New York. No wonder he's going Biden, because he wants all the attention off him right now.